Thus saith the Lord, I know the thoughts that I think toward you, thoughts of peace and not of evil. Ye shall call upon me, and I will hearken unto you, and will turn away your captivity from all the nations. Lord, thou art become gracious unto thy land. Thou hast turned away the captivity of Jacob. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Thus saith the Lord, I know the thoughts that I think toward you, thoughts of peace and not of evil. Ye shall call upon me, and I will hearken unto you, and will turn away your captivity from all the nations. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Stir up, we beseech thee, O Lord, the wills of thy faithful people, that they, plenteously bringing forth the fruit of good works, may by thee be plenteously rewarded. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, art one God, world without end.
Amen.
The portion of Scripture appointed to be read for the epistle is found in the 23rd chapter of the book of Jeremiah, beginning at the 5th verse. In those days Jeremiah the prophet spake, saying, Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will raise unto David a righteous branch, and a king shall reign and prosper, and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth. In his days Judah shall be saved, and Israel shall dwell safely. And this is his name whereby he shall be called, the Lord our righteousness. Therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that they shall no more say, The Lord liveth which brought up the children out of Israel, out of the land of Egypt, but the Lord liveth which brought up and which led the seed of the house of Israel out of the north country and from all countries whither I had driven them, and they shall dwell in their own land. Here endeth the epistle.
And thanks be to God.
It is thou, O Lord, that savest us from our enemies, and puttest them to confusion that hate us. We make our boast of God all day long, and will praise thy name forever. Alleluia, alleluia. Out of the deep have I called unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 6th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the 5th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he saith unto Philip, Whence shall we buy bread that these may eat? And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 pennyworth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, saith unto him, There is a lad here which hath 5 barley loaves and 2 small fishes, but what are they among so many? And Jesus said, Make the men sit down. Now there was much grass in the place, and so the men sat down in number about 5,000. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes, as much as they would. When they were filled, he said unto his disciples, Gather up the fragments that remain, that nothing be lost. And therefore they gathered them together and filled 12 baskets with the fragments of the 5 barley loaves, which remained over and above unto them that had eaten. Then those men, when they had seen the miracle that Jesus did, said, This is of a truth that prophet that should come into the world.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. The third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth in the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe in one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and life in the world to come. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today we complete the season of Trinity with a Sunday that is called Sunday Next Before Advent, but it's commonly called Stir Up Sunday, and it's called that because of what we ask God to do for us in the collect for this day. Stir up, O Lord, the souls of thy faithful people to good works. So what is it really to have one's will stirred up more than we have it on normal days? Well, it is to know that you are in the presence of God, that God is with you in life and enables you to experience all the things that he would have us experience: goodness and wholeness and love and peace and joy, the full and sanctified life. That's to be stirred up. Today we look to John's gospel story, the feeding of the 5,000, that miraculous event that we are told about in the gospel reading for this day, for a bit more insight. And when we do, we see that Jesus and his disciples went up onto a mountain, and he sat down, and a lot of people had followed him because they had seen the miracles that he had done in the past. And so he asked Philip, who was with him, he said, how are we going to buy bread for these folk? And Philip said, hey, there's no way we can do it. We don't have enough money. That's what he said. But then there's Andrew. And he looked around, and he saw a boy with 5 loaves of barley bread and a couple fish. Now, barley bread is the cheapest bread of the time. So the child did not have all that much, did he? But he told Jesus about what the boy had. And then he said, but what are they among so many? The operative word in his response to Jesus was but. You know, that's the great disclaimer. Which, you know, when someone uses that, it signals that the person who's talking is in the process of giving up. You know, it's the short word for however, you know. And so, you know, they're in the process of giving up and will shortly be in transition maybe from a life of action to a life of non-action or, God forbid, withdrawal. You know, here's an example of it, you know, and I don't know, I suppose we've heard this before. I love you, but. That's when you duck, because it's not going to be good. You can just rest assured it's not going to be good. So the two disciples were found lacking in their understanding of what was happening. They didn't understand. They didn't know in whose presence they were. They knew it was Jesus, but they didn't realize it was the presence of God that was with them. They didn't know in whose presence they were and what that could and would mean to the events of the day. I believe that we have that same temptation in our own day and age also. There's a Cappadocian priest of the 4th century called Gregory of Nazianzus who put it this way. He said, if you do away with counting the cost, what will be the result? Something great and wonderful. Well, this time the lesson was simple, wasn't it? Jesus took the loaves and the fish. He prayed over them. He distributed them to the people. All the people ate and they were all filled. And then they gathered up the leftovers and had 12 baskets filled with bread. That was a miracle, and the people knew it. You see, we all need to have our wills stimulated to the possibility of the miraculous, especially in this day and age in which we live, which people are just kind of, you know, bored with life and think that everything, the walls are come tumbling down on their lives. And so today we pray that we would be stirred up to bring forth the fruit of good works. That's what the prayer says this day. Well, what are these things called good works? Do we have to make them up ourselves? No, we don't. They're the works of mercy. There's the 14 works of mercy. And it's the way we act out our love of God and our fellow neighbor. Okay? The works of mercy. Corporal and spiritual, and the things like feeding the hungry and giving drink to the thirsty, clothing the naked, we've got them all. You know, there's 7 corporal works of mercy, and then there are 7 spiritual works. And they bring miracles into the lives of us all. If we are the ones who administer the works of mercy, they bring miracles, the miraculous, into our life, and most assuredly, the people who receive those things also they are experiencing the miraculous. Now, as I said already, life has a tendency to dull us after a while to the goodness and the joyfulness and the blessings that God offers us in His Son's name. Just surviving, just hanging on, which a lot of people are doing in our day and age, doesn't make you a saint. It doesn't do much of anything for you. It is when you and I allow God to stir up our wills so that we bring forth the fruit of good works that we become sanctified and then saintly and have the ability to participate in the miraculous. Now, it's a little bit over 30 days until we meet Christ in the manger when we celebrate the incarnation. to help us make ready to see Jesus more clearly in the manger, but also to know of his second coming when he'll come to judge the world, the quick and the dead. And then that's going to be a glorious day too. To help us to make ready for those events, here are three things that I think we can begin doing even right now, this day. First, right now, realize that you are in the presence of God. Acknowledge that and allow him to stir up your will more fully. And then number two, spend more time with Christ, with God. How do we do that? Prayer, Bible reading, get closer to him, hang around through your hunger, and we all thirst and hunger for him, I am sure. Break bread with the faithful consistently in the Lord's house on the Lord's day at the Lord's table. On your knees and be lifted up and soar in his love. And if you do, you will be pulled up to a higher level where both Christ and the miraculous mingle together. You know, when we worship, we actually get beyond the form and we almost are levitating off of the ground and being pulled into the presence of God himself. Number three and finally, never, never, never feel small or insignificant in your work for God. Always remember the lad and what happened when he gave what he had to the Lord. I think here's the bottom line of it all, of what to do and not do with our life, this blessing that we have, life in this world. If you're thinking about doing something, and you don't know if you should be doing it or not, if you are thinking about whether doing certain things are good or bad, then just answer this question. Does it glorify God? And if it does, do what you can and share what you have. You see, God takes that which you and I give in faith, no matter how small we may think it is, and multiplies it to the point of the miraculous. And if you don't believe that, you just haven't tried it yet. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. All things come of thee, O Lord,
and thine own have we given thee. Amen.
We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, with the prayer that we may use the time that we have before the celebration of the Incarnation to grow in Christ and to embrace the miracles that he offers us in his Son's name. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Lord, receive the sacrifice of thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all the whole church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
He who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Everlasting God, Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord our God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify, with thy word and Holy Spirit, these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray now as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come, and at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being holpen by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietude, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
See the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord, and that's my strength and my salvation. Lord. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Lord,
I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee.
Amen.
Preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Eat and drink this in the remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful. Amen. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when ye pray, believe that you receive them, and ye shall have them. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Depart in peace. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.